What's up, guys? Today we are talking about our favorite t-shirts.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to gentslounge. I'm George. This is Blake. If you have not hit that subscribe button yet, hit that right now. We are here every week talking about men's fashion, lifestyle, and today, our favorite t-shirts. Now, guys, this is not just about one t-shirt. This video is not sponsored. These are the t-shirts that are in our closet, what we wear on a regular basis, and most of these are over a year old, so we know that they can wear in. So we get asked all the time, what is the best t-shirt? And the answer is like, well, what do you want to do? What do you want to wear it for? How tall are you? How muscular are you? So the right t-shirt for you is not necessarily the right t-shirt for me. Like, me and Blake have completely different styles, sizes, and things that we look for in a t-shirt. So my picks might not be exactly the same as Blake's picks, but I'm going to give you the reasons, and Blake's going to give you the reasons of why he picked his and why I picked mine. So I think for me, the most important thing when it comes to a t-shirt is something that washes well, doesn't shrink in the wash, keeps its shape, and doesn't get like a funky texture after you wash. You know how some t-shirts get like pilly and gross? So all of my t-shirts in my selection I've had for over a year, they wash easily. I don't have to hang dry them. I don't have to baby them because they're t-shirts, guys. If I'm gonna baby some clothes, it's gonna be a more expensive dress shirt or a suit, but I'm not trying to spend all this time washing and drying and hang drying t-shirts.
I want a shirt that looks good, feels good, and makes me feel good, quite frankly. You know, so like it has to be like fitted, but not too fitted. You know, I'm not the type of guy who wears like that Freddie Mercury super tight shirt, you know, but I do want to feel like, you know, a little muscular, even though I'm not quite muscular, you know. But today I'm wearing what I call like my casual, my everyday t-shirt. This is from Todd Snyder. This is a very relaxed fit. It's not tight at all. I've owned it since, we're in 2019, since 2016.
Yes, guys, so there are different types of t-shirts for different types of occasions, different textures, different weights that work well for, you know, a denim jacket versus a suit jacket if you're gonna go as an undershirt type deal. So we're gonna just kind of fly through these brands real quick because there's 8 of them, and if we spent too much time, this would be a very, very long video. So for Blake, Todd Snyder was his first one. I'm a huge fan of BYLT. Basically, they make a luxe and like a regular premium version. I like the premium cotton better than the luxe because the luxe is a little bit stretchier and it's a little too snug for me in the medium, which I like to wear kind of a slimmer t-shirt. I love these t-shirts. They're super comfortable. They're definitely not a shirt that I would wear with a suit because you see these little like kind of stitchings around the arms and whatnot. It's just kind of a little too casual to dress up this type of a t-shirt.
All right, guys, so for my second shirt, this is like my most luxurious of shirts, and this is one of my most casual t-shirts. It's by Mack Weldon. It's about $45, so it's not too expensive. You know, it's 100% Pima cotton. It's very, very comfortable, very relaxed. I typically use these with just t-shirt and jeans, and I don't tuck it in. So this is like my day-to-day t-shirt. What I like about them is that they're not super fitted. They're a little loose, and I think they make their shirts for like every type of guy, you know? So they're not like for your muscular guy, they're not for your like your chubby guy. It's just a regular shirt. It's like an elevated Hanes.
All right, guys, up next is my most luxurious shirt. This is by Jason Scott. And this is the shirt I wear with the suit. I've had these for so long. I wear the crap out of them. They wash well. They're just really, really nice. It's Peruvian cotton, so it's super,
it's
super
nice,
soft.
Yeah.
This is the most expensive t-shirt, I think, in this area. This is like $68, but
which is a lot for a t-shirt.
It's a lot of money.
Yeah, for a t-shirt. We're not talking, there's no graphics on there. It's just a regular plain t-shirt.
But I've had these for 4 years.
I fucking love them, dude.
So, I mean.
I love them.
It is an investment, and it does seem like a lot, but if you've had the same t-shirt for 4 years, you're definitely spending way more than $80 on Hanes t-shirts because you're going through those, the neck stretches out, they don't wash well. So, you know, spend your money on quality pieces, and I think every shirt in this selection is a quality piece that will last you a good year plus.
So my third shirt here is from Express. This is more of your economical shirt. It's only, I mean, today I brought like a salmon color one, but they have like various different colors. This one here is $22, okay? So it's nicely priced. And for the most part, they're always about 30% off. So you can get this shirt for anywhere from $12 to $20. Sometimes they have a buy one, get one free. This is not sponsored, guys. I mean, I am really a fan of these shirts. They have that moisture wickening one that doesn't, like when you're sweating, it doesn't really show a lot, or it kind of hides the sweat. That's why I'm a big fan of them. This is probably my least expensive of the shirts, but the one I wear mostly with suits.
Last but not least for me, I have Buck Mason, and I think this is the best bang for your buck t-shirt.
Oh, these, no pun intended.
Hey, right? These are like $32, and I've had this one for another 4 years at least, but it's the heather gray, which I think is, I don't know, this, it gives a nice texture and makes the t-shirt kind of a little interesting for being plain. So you can kind of wear this under a, I wear this under a denim jacket constantly, and it just, you know, probably with this hat as well.
Yeah, I mean, this but I think Buck Mason does more of like your Americana style.
They're made in America, like, yeah. It's like you could hop on a motorcycle, and I love it.
Yeah, they're not quite cowboy, but they're not quite hipster. They're like in between. They're cool. I'm a fan of them. You know, I know the guys really well. They've been doing shirts for a while. I mean, it's a good shirt, right?
It's one of the best made shirts, and it's made in America, so, you know, you're supporting American jobs and American labor, so. A plus to Buck Mason.
All right. So now up next, Captain America, we have ESNTLS. So I'm sure you guys know of Jose Zuniga teaching men's fashion. He decided, him and his brother, they did their own t-shirt line. Well, now it's a full-on fashion line. But they do pretty kick-ass t-shirts, really soft, really fitted. This is a shirt that's going to make you feel muscular, even if you're not quite muscular. They have, it's really soft, like I'm saying. I typically would wear these with like jeans or even like a sweats. I kind of elevate my look when I'm wearing it, but I keep it very, very minimal.
So when I said some shirts aren't meant for both Blake and I, this is one of the shirts that I'm talking about. I have these shirts out of the bag. They're luxurious, they're comfortable, they're amazing t-shirts, except for me, the large, which is what size I usually wear, fits me in the arms perfectly, but squeezes me like extra tight around the midsection. And you know, if I've had a pretty good sized meal that day, you can see the meal.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
You know, sometimes an XL is just too big for me. So if you're not like looking for like a super loose fitted t-shirt, make sure you size up, I would say.
Yeah, these are more trimmed of the fits.
And the fabric is like, it's elastic, it like stretches, but it squeezes you a little bit.
All right, guys, so lastly, we have Apollos. This is a shirt I've been wearing, I want to say 5 years, 6 years when I first started blogging, even before that. What I like about Apollos is that they actually put thought into who's making their shirts. So they go around the world and they source a specific fabric, but they get it made in an area from like Africa to Mexico to Peru to Colombia, and they really, really put thought into making sure that who's ever making a shirt is actually getting paid a good amount, you know? And they're a good brand. I've been wearing this shirt, like I said, 5 years. I've worn the shit out of this shirt right here. I wore it to Hong Kong, to India, in New York. I washed it about like 40, 50 times. It's a good shirt. It's trim. This one fits you a lot like the Buck Mason. So it has that like just casual feel to it, not too luxurious, but you know it is a higher price shirt in that it is about $35.
Right, so that pretty much wraps up our favorite t-shirts. We will have links to all these down below. But remember guys, not every t-shirt is right for you or the style that you're wanting to wear. So, you know, if you're wearing suits, you definitely want to look for a nicer collar, a nice texture, kind of a smoother shirt. And if you're going casual, obviously you can wear pretty much anything. But if you're trying to elevate and dress things up, it's probably a different t-shirt than your denim and jacket, heather gray type t-shirt. And obviously fits are gonna be different for different types of people. Yes. Like I'm a bigger guy than Blake, so what fits me well doesn't necessarily fit Blake well and vice versa. So remember that, you know, you gotta think about your size, how tall you are, how long the shirt is. There's a lot more than just like me telling you this is the best t-shirt ever, go buy it now. So that's why we have 8 different brands here that are very, very well-made t-shirts and different price points, different categories, but I ramble. So that pretty much wraps up the video. We'll have links to all these down below. If you haven't hit that subscribe button yet, hit that right now. If you haven't followed us on Instagram at gentslounge, give us a follow over there. And if we missed your favorite t-shirt, comment what your favorite t-shirt is down below and we will take a look at it. Cheers, guys.
Cheers.